Have you heard of TENS? Transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulation. It's a type of electrical current that is applied to the skin to stimulate the peripheral nerves and relieve pain. There are some types of pain that respond well to TENS, mostly acute pain, like pain after an injury, trauma, post-surgical, and menstrual cramps. Today, I will explain how you apply this modality to get the most of your TENS machine. So let's talk about TENS today. Before I continue, let me remind you that this video is not intended to replace medical advice. It's for educational purposes only. You should contact your doctor for proper diagnosis and treatment plan for you. And in case of emergencies, go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. TENS is a machine that delivers low voltage current that has some specific patterns and frequencies to be able to reduce pain. We don't know exactly how TENS works to reduce acute pain, but there are many reports that TENS is effective to treat acute pain, mostly after an injury to a tendon, muscle, bone, or ligament. Also, post-surgical pain and menstrual cramps. There are patients who use TENS for headaches, neck pain, neuropathic pain, and diabetic neuropathy. I usually suggest them to try TENS before buying the equipment. And if it works, they can use the machine every day. There are no side effects with TENS. There are some people who should not use TENS. For example, if they have some electrical devices implanted in their body, for example, a pacemaker, a brain stimulator, a spinal cord stimulator, and people who have epilepsy should not apply close to the neck or head. TENS should not be applied in areas of the skin that are wounds or infections. The skin has to be healthy and intact. You can purchase a TENS device in almost every pharmacy in Canada. In other parts of the world, maybe you need to ask a physiotherapist where you can buy one of this. I will put some links in the description of this video below of some TENS machine that you can buy online. This video is not being sponsored by any of those machines. I bought my machine maybe 10 years ago when I was at a pain conference. I really like it and I use it almost every time that I have an acute pain episode. The machine is small. It has a rechargeable battery and I tell my patients to apply TENS and if it relieves their pain, then they can leave it as long as they want. You can put it in your pocket, you can carry it in your pocket and carry it with you. The problem is that the body will adapt to the current in about 30 minutes and then the pain will return. That's why it's important to have a machine when you buy that can have many options, like mine here has 12 different options of frequencies and waves. The TENS current can be basically two types, high frequency, which is around 100 Hertz, and low frequency, which is around 2 Hertz. High frequency TENS is known as conventional TENS. It's pleasant, does not bother the person. You feel the shock and stop feeling the pain. The pain relief is almost immediate with conventional TENS. And as soon as you turn the machine off, the pain immediately comes back. Conventional TENS works by competing with the painful sensation at the spinal cord. This is known as the gate control theory. So there is only one gate to send the impulse. It's either carrying the electrical impulse, the electricity from the TENS, or carrying the painful sensation to go to the brain. So if the gate is closed by TENS, the pain cannot travel. Low frequency TENS is known as acupuncture-like TENS. It is a bit unpleasant. You feel like needles entering the skin, and this type of electrical current activates areas of the brain that are similar to the areas activated by acupuncture. These areas in the brain will produce endorphins, and therefore the effects of this acupuncture-like TENS will last for hours or many days after the machine is turned off. So here is the TENS machine. So you see, this is the TENS machine that I have, and it's a small, like a cell phone, And when I turn on, you see that it has all these different types of options here. And this one here is, we select which type here in the mode. So it changed to, this is more like acupuncture-like. And number three. So each one of those is a different type of current. Some of them are high frequency, some are low frequency. And then what we have, and here is, are the two channels. So it's asking for the channel, first the channel A. So what I'm going to do is, this is channel A here. So right here, channel A. And then it's linked to this pads here. So then what I do is I just connect to one pad and the other one. So then I can connect the second channel here, would be here, channel B. And then I can put other pads around the body. So here, another pair. So this is pair B and this is pair A, right? And so each one of those pairs, we will attach to different parts of the body. So the current will go from this to this. The one that I will adjust the intensity here on the, so channel A is blinking now, so it's controlling this two pads here, this channel. And then if I change here, A or B, now it's blinking B, so this means that I'm controlling now the intensity of the this channel or these two pads. So the way it works is I attach the pads to a body part that I'm going to treat. So let's say that I have pain here. Let's say that it's tendinitis here. So I attach the pads here and here, right? Let's say that I want to treat this area of pain. And I'm using these ones are attached to channel B. So what happens, you see channel B is blinking. So now I am going to increase the intensity. And here is increasing the intensity. Now I'm feeling, I'm feeling this like a needle coming through my skin here, but it's not uncomfortable. It's not pain. It's just an electrical shock. And I can increase the intensity. If I keep increasing the intensity here, you see, so this channel B is increasing. And the higher I go, the more I feel. So this would be enough. Oh. There is some muscle contractions here. So when you see some muscle contraction, like you are seeing here, this is not tense. This is electrical muscle stimulation. So I need to choose a different type of mode here. So I choose this in the M, the mode. So now it goes to 4. And you see when you change to a different mode of electrical stimulation, it automatically the intensity goes to 0. And you have to start increasing the intensity all over again. So now I'm feeling a different type of current. So this one, you see, there is no muscle contraction. I'm not moving the muscles. And what I'm feeling here is exactly like this. It's like a ball rolling, like a roll going from here to here. So it's just going like a roll. And it's pleasant. It's nice. And I can increase the intensity. Oh, this is a little too much. Yeah, this is high already, and I'm feeling like a ball here, rolling here. But it's, again, it's not painful. And you see there's no muscle contraction with this number 4. And then I can go to, let's say, number 5. The drawing there looks like there is a needle. So let me see. So I start increasing the intensity. It's not like a needle. It's more like a acupuncture, when the acupuncture needle is doing stimulation like this, that's how this one feels like. And then you can play around. So what I do is I play around, I put in the area of pain that I'm feeling pain, and then I try a couple of them and I see which one abolishes the pain, which one is best for my pain. So the if you remember well, the high frequency will eliminate the pain right away, the low frequency, you will still have some pain, but the low frequency tense, it's going to release those endorphins, dynorphins, and cephalines, and they will accumulate in the brain and help the pain relief to last days, sometimes up to 7 days. So that's why I like tens, because you can mix different currents. And you can apply, like I could apply the other pads in a different part of the body and at the same time have current here and current in another part. Let's say that I would, if I wanted to apply a pad here and here to treat elbow pain, I could do that. You adjust the intensity of channel A and B, but the current is the same. Whatever it's the type of the mode of current that is applying here is the same here, and when you change, changes both at the same time. So you see, it's not difficult. It's pleasant. Like here, I'm feeling the electrical shock going from one to the other one. I'm using like mode 6. Let's say if I change to mode 7. And then increase the intensity here. Yeah, I'm feeling it's a different type of current. And again, if you see muscle contraction, then it's not tense. It's electrical muscle stimulation, but tense does not move the muscles. So this one is tense and it's okay. It's pleasant and you can apply and use it. So when you buy your machine, you may also check if it comes with different pads. For example, this is one really nice because these two pads can be attached to the low back area, the lower back for low back pain. So it comes with this strap, and so then you can close here. So then you can wrap it around your lower back. And what you do is, so you put your channel 1, and you just attach here and here. So then these two pads will be delivering. This is good for low back pain, but also for menstrual cramps. You put this on the back and then alleviates menstrual cramps. The other type of pads that came with this machine that I bought is for the feet. So here we have, so you can attach the pads here and here. Here, the electrodes you attach here. So then once you regulate the current here, you're going to notice current that delivers from these three parts here. So you put your feet here and then you will feel electrical shocks on the bottom of your feet. So this is good for plantar fasciitis, for foot pain, pain arthritis. So when you buy your machine, you may take a look to see if they come with different pads and different ways of attaching to your body. These are the sites for application of the electrodes. So this one here is if the person has shoulder pain and pain in the back of the shoulder and upper back, they can apply these pads from one channel on the top of the shoulder and the pads of the second channel in the around the shoulder blade on the same side. Now this one is if the person has pain on both shoulders and it's more on the like upper back and trapezius area. So they can apply one channel on the right side and one channel on the left side. And this one is for pain in the front of the shoulder. So the person can apply one channel, the two pads around the deltoid area, and the other one in the pectoralis area in front of the shoulder. The next one here is for pain in the elbow and pain in the wrist. So they can apply the pads above and below the elbow, and the other channel, the pads go above and below the wrist. This here is for pain in the upper back and lower back. So for this one, the person may, if the person has pain on one side of the back, for example, the left side, and so they can apply one channel in the upper back and the other one in the lower back. And this one is if the person has pain in the mid thoracic area and on both, like around the both of the shoulder blades. So they can apply one channel on the left side and one channel on the right side. And here's the reverse. If they have pain more in the middle of the back, the upper back area, this is more like pain in the rhomboids muscle. So they can cross the channels here. You see the green means the first channel. So one patch is on the left side upper area, and the second green one is on the right side in the lower area, and the other channel is reversed. So the current is concentrated in the midpoint. This one here is for pain, the low back pain area. So one channel is on the left side, the other one is on the right side, and they apply above and below the pain area. This one is if the pain is right in the middle of the lower back, so they can cross. One channel crossing right and left, and the other channel crossing left and right. So here is for elbow pain. So this is for lateral epicondylitis. So they can put one patch above the elbow and the other one below the elbow. This one is for menstrual cramps. For menstrual cramps, the person can put the pads on the back, the lower back, but they can also put in the front. So they can put a one right and left, the first channel, the green one. They put one pad on the right side and one on the left side, and the other channel they put below the inguinal area. And for this one is pain in the hips. So right and left hip, this could be helpful for bursitis, trochanteric bursitis. So they put one channel on the right and the other channel on the left. This is for neck pain, more like a cervical pain, and sternocleidomastoid area, scalenes muscles. So they can put one patch right below the ear and the other one close to the collarbone. Here is for knee pain. So here they can put the pads above and below the knee. They can cross the pads, for example, the right and left, they can cross. This one is also for knee pain, so they can put the pads more on the lateral side of the knee instead of putting on the front of the knee. This is for Achilles tendinitis, which is a type of a heel pain, and they can put one patch above and the other one below the Achilles tendon. So here is for foot pain, and they can, this is if a person has a strain or a sprain of the ankle, for example, they can put the pads above and below the tendon, ligaments here of the ankle. And also if they have of the foot itself, the metatarsal area, this is good if they have an inflammation, like a tendinitis or a sprain of the foot, they can put below and above. And last, this is for foot pain, more localized in like the plantar fasciitis, and they can put the pads on the bottom of the foot and apply the current. So they put one channel on the left foot and the other channel on the right foot. So here's a summary. If you want, you can download this handout. There is a link in the description of this video below, and you can download this handout with all these pictures. So you can print and use with your TENS machine.
So that's all that I had about TENS today. If you're interested in purchasing a machine, as I said, there are some links in the video description below. And talk to your doctor about this, if this is indicated for you. Also ask a physiotherapist. If you have your physiotherapist, ask them to try a TENS machine before you buy your own, so you can see if it works for you or not. So if you like this video, give your thumbs up here. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and turn on the notifications. And watch my next video here, don't forget. Thank you for watching today. Goodbye.